Hey everybody, welcome back to Salted Hash. I'm your host, Steve Reagan, and today we're going to be talking about virus total intelligence with Carl Hiramoto. So stay tuned and we'll be right back. All right, so as I promised earlier, we are in Black Hat in Las Vegas. It's hot and humid outside, so we're up in a suite now here at the Mandalay Bay, Four Seasons to be more specific. But Carl here has something really cool to show you, and it's called Virus Total Intelligence. So really quickly, give me a brief overview of what this is.
So Virus Total Intelligence is like a search engine. Like, think of it as a Google search engine where you can search for any type of malware. You can search based on what type of malware it is, what type of detection it has, what it does in a sandbox, what any other behavior or any type of metadata you can think of is searchable in intelligence.
And the interesting thing about that is that's kind of what people have come to expect from Virus Total, but there's a lot more that this product can do, which is thread things together to find the hidden or often overlooked commonalities or connections between things. So like incident responders, for example.
Yeah, for incident responders, it's great to see, like, you know, when was it uploaded, how many people have uploaded it, the time span, and like the evolution of like detection of maybe it started with a few detections and then detections grew, or then comments on the file or any type of extra data we gather as time goes on.
So today we were going to look at some macOS malware, I think you were talking.
Yep.
So let's walk through that. Show me what this thing can do.
So we have in this case we have a fake Dropbox installer.
Mm-hmm.
So we have the Dropbox installer here in the middle. And we have relationships between different things. So here it's in a container, in a contained DMG file. And then in the sandbox, it calls out to these other contacted domains, other servers. And then you can see where this file was downloaded from. So we know that this fake installer is downloaded from this host here and all these different URLs. You can see then commonalities with other adware in the same family.
Mm-hmm.
So like, if you know like Popcorn Time or HP Printer Manager, they're fake drivers, they're all related from the same company. And you can see that visually here in the graph. And then if you click on the individual sample, you can click the link to the free public report, which is what
we would get if we were to upload it on the Virus Total
website.
Correct.
And then there's the intelligence side report, which has the more detailed information.
Mm-hmm.
So we'd have like submissions where there could be multiple submissions over a period of time.
Mm-hmm.
And then we would have the dates on the first submission, last submission. And in the behavior tab, you have sandboxed information.
And so how much of this is stuff you can get directly by accessing it public, the free version, like you said, and then how much of this is on top of, like, the stuff?
So, like, the extra stuff is, like, in intelligence, you can do YARA hunting, so you can search with your own signatures. You can write own signatures unique to your company and then get notifications when something hits that signature.
Which is really good, because if you're writing your own signatures, then if a criminal crew or even another security researcher, if they upload something that comes in contact with your signatures, then you get the alert.
Yeah.
So now you know that either A, this is out there, or somebody has seen something that you thought. So like if I found something suspicious on my network and I was curious about it, I wrote a signature.
Yeah.
Now, if anybody else sees that thing, I've got a pattern. I've
Correct.
Got something I can look
yeah.
for. Okay.
And so, and also in the sandbox analysis, we have like screenshots of how the install process goes. So in this case, they're like faking it's a booking or Dropbox application. And then
it's
you get all the operations.
Yeah.
It runs through the install. And then we gather data, and that goes all in the reports.
Nice.
So I can show you. Here's in the hunting tab.
Mm-hmm.
We have different where you can load the signatures here. So you write your own signatures in YARA.
Yep.
And then you can get email notifications, or we also have RSS feeds, or JSON. And then there's an interface here with all the hits you get.
You could also take that feed and import it into whatever backend you want. So like if you've got a SIM somewhere and you want to dump this stuff into, you can pull it from that, or
yeah.
you can just keep your own custom configs going. So when you're doing the hunting with the signatures and stuff like that, it's not just new uploads as well. You can go back and it shows you everything that's been uploaded in the past.
Correct.
As well. So when you write these signatures, you can search.
Yep, you can search over time, and it's useful for people searching, like you find version 10 of the malware, but you want to go back and search for version 9, and then you want to go back and try and go back in time and find the evolution of the malware.
So you guys have been testing this for a while. I first saw it earlier this year, shortly after RSA, and I know there's been some improvements. What kind of feedback are you getting from customers who have tried it?
On intelligence? Most people love it.
Intelligence and hunting and all that.
So we're getting, we're going to include like more data. We're going to include icon search. We're going to include, a lot of PDF installers, they'll have the fake PDF icon, or and then you can search everything with the same icon.
Ooh, that would be neat. So you can find groups who use the same art in all of their various campaigns.
Correct.
You'd be able to find those groups.
You can find the artwork.
Or know who's sharing between the two.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then another cool feature here is in intelligence. We can click and find this. Here's the water cry example.
Mm-hmm.
But we can find similar examples. So there's fuzzy hashing. So you can search by import hash or search by SSD. And we have our own in-house similar to query, which is similar to, and then you say
brings
the hash and you find everything
similar
is similar to that file.
Which would be good for going for those variants that companies are always quick to hide behind, when in reality it's something minor updated on the malware.
The same cluster of malware, or same family will often get same hits.
Nice. Well, it's like I said earlier when I first saw this was just really cool, because everybody knows VirusTotal, but there's a lot more you can do on the back end, so I thought that was worth exploring. Thanks again, Carl. I really appreciate talking to me. If you'd like to learn more about VirusTotal Intelligence or any other type of malware attacks, remember to check us out online at cso.online.com. This has been Salted Hash, and I'm your host, Steve Reagan. We'll see you soon.